Hey Fit Fam, it's your girl Sidney and I'm back with another video. So today we're gonna talk about why I f***ing hate dieting. And with that being said, I want to just say that I get a ton of emails, and this is kind of what prompted the whole video. Is I specifically got an email that said like, hey Sidney, I do a lot of like your workouts, but I really don't know what to eat, so I tried this diet called the military diet and I wanted to know what your thoughts were. I lost weight in the beginning and now I'm gaining weight. And that was basically what the email said. And it made me think like, why are people that are, and she was 13, and I was just like, why are you dieting? Like, girl, it's not that, like, some diets, they can be good if they fit your lifestyle, but like, this one clearly didn't fit her lifestyle, and it made me really start thinking about like this topic, and then I realized I really wanted to talk about it. Also, if you guys wanna follow me on my fitness account on Instagram, I will have it right on the bottom. If you guys are not subscribed, please do. The first definition is not what a lot of people assume it is. When people say they're going on a diet, it's usually restrictive, which is the second definition, which is a special course of food to which one restricts oneself, either to lose weight or for medical reasons. Being on a diet is not gonna make it lifelong and long term, and I'm gonna touch on a few different things, and this is my personal opinion, and I wanna state that right now. Like, there are some people that are all for going on diets. If you guys have different opinions, please comment them down below. But with that being said, let's get into it. You guys, a little background. For those of you that don't know me, you guys just came to my channel and you're like, Sidney, why the heck are you talking about dieting? First thing, I'm an exercise and wellness major at Arizona State University. I have lost 55 pounds. I did that in high school and I've been able to keep it off, love my body, treat it well. I reversed having high cholesterol. I was pre-diabetic. I was very depressed. I was borderline suicidal and I was severely obese. So I know what it's like to have to deal with diets and feeling like that's the only way you're gonna see results is by going on a restrictive diet. I just wanna clear the air on that and say that's why I feel like I can talk about this and I have knowledge on this, because I've gone through it and I've seen other people go through it, because being my exercise and wellness major and then also coaching girls and stuff, I've been able to kind of like be on both sides of it. So dieting is not the answer to weight loss. The answer to weight loss is being in a deficit of your calories and having some exercise and just like creating it into a lifestyle, because at the end of the day, if you want to lose weight and keep it off, you are not going to be seeing results in 5 years off the same plan, but at the same time you are going to gain all the way back if it's a diet. And I want to capitalize on that. Like, some people can keep a diet up for like 2 years, but then the moment that you step away from that diet that's very restrictive, you're gonna gain all the way back, because you will have one of those moments where you're like, wow, I can actually eat food, I can do all these things, and then you're gonna just bounce back. You're gonna binge or whatever people do in your lifestyle, and that's what a lot of people do. The moment their diet ended, which it shouldn't end, it should become a lifestyle, which is where people think that like diets are, you know, short term. I'm in a diet for 6 weeks, look great for spring break and still look great afterwards and feel great. But what happens is people set a limit on their diet. They don't create it into a lifestyle. It never turns into anything other than just that, you know, 2 to 3 week diet that they want to do just to look good for something. There is no harm in wanting to look good for something, but if you want the consistent result and you don't want to have it backfire later on and gain double the amount of weight or something, you want to make it a lifestyle. And that's one of the biggest things I want to capitalize on in this video, is the reason I think you should say dieting is because the number one reason people fail their diet is because it's too restrictive. And if you are doing a diet that's restricting you and making you feel like you can't do things in your daily life, you're getting depressed from it, you're, you know, failing at your diet every week and having to restart, it's probably because that diet doesn't work for you. And diets don't really work. At the end of the day, if it's a lifestyle and you're making these changes over time and you're incorporating them with time, then you're gonna be so much more successful, because in 20 years, you will not have gained double the weight. You will be, as long as you're sticking with things and doing things that fit your lifestyle, you will be so much better off. I realized in the beginning I was dieting hard. Like, I was literally cutting everything out. I was restricting myself, which is a diet. And to this day, I still sometimes will like go onto these little frenzies and be like, oh my god, I need to lose weight. And then I like eat really healthy one day. The next day I go to In-N-Out, get animal style fries, a chocolate shake, and a double double. So like, it's one of those things where it's like, if you put yourself in such a restriction, eventually it's gonna backfire and it's gonna turn into something else. And I've struggled with this too, so I completely get it. But if you are someone that is asking for advice on whether or not to diet, don't. Turn it into a lifestyle. Make it something that you can keep up. Because in 20 years, you don't want to look back at your high school years and be like, wow, I really wish I had that body. In that time that you were in high school, you know, you were trying so hard to lose weight, but then you're looking and you're like, all this dieting really fucked up my metabolism. It made me view myself with differently than I should have. Like, I should have appreciated myself at that point. It ended up backfiring and I gained double the weight, you know? And I think that that's one of the biggest struggles that a lot of people deal with, is they gain twice the weight back because they lose it so quickly, and then they binge because they were restrictive, and it just becomes a vicious cycle. So for those of you that are wanting to diet, don't. Instead, turn it into a lifestyle. Make it something that you can do on the daily basis. You don't feel guilty. You can still maintain a social life. It's all about balance. Dieting doesn't have to be bad or hard. You can have a vegetarian diet and not restrict food if you want to be vegetarian. Like, if that's something that you genuinely want to be, like, I don't consider that a diet, if that makes sense. Like, I consider the kinds of foods that you're eating is fine, but like, the moment you start restricting and you go into like HGG and you're eating 500 calories a day, a diet can be, if you go vegetarian because, like, you know, you just want to lose weight and then you're going to get off of it, that's a fad diet. And I think the big thing too is the fact that if it's a lifestyle, you know, start cutting out meat slowly and then go into eating only fish as a pescatarian, then can, you know, keep going. Because at the end of the day, if you go vegetarian within 24 hours, you're not going to stick with it. And I think that's like one of the biggest things that I've noticed. And I'm not trying to say that you guys can't do it because you don't have willpower, but 3 months down the line, you're gonna see a steak and you're gonna be like, wow, I really want that. And then you're going to eat that steak and then you're gonna eat 20 more of them. And it's just one of those things, it becomes a vicious cycle, and I really don't wanna see you guys ever struggle. And so that's why I'm kind of bringing this up, because I feel like it's so important to say, f*** dieting. And that's kind of my whole spiel for today. I just wanted to come on here and say, after I got that email and I've received multiple other ones, I realized that, like, it becomes a vicious cycle. It's not healthy for you and it's not lifelong. If you really want to see results, put in the work, be consistent, and you'll see the results. It took me 8 months to look in the mirror one day and be like, holy crap, I lost like 40 pounds. At that point, I looked in the mirror and it never even hit me. I realized after it happened that I was losing weight. I didn't even notice when I had lost like 10 pounds. Like, I did not see any differences, but then it all adds up. The little changes are what add up. And if you really want to lose weight and you want to stick with it and you want to stay healthy and fit and happy and not have your body yo-yo and be like a size 10 1 week and then a size 2 another because you're yo-yoing and you're just not doing it the healthy way and you're wrecking your metabolism, make it a lifestyle. Don't make it a diet. Don't make it a fad diet, because at the end of the day, people always end up regretting those. And if you have never done one, or you've done it and you agree with me, comment down below. I'm just curious. I want to know your opinion, and I hope this video helped you. I know that it wasn't, like, you know, not common knowledge, but I feel like it needed to be said on my channel because I haven't really talked about it that much, and I feel like it's important. And yeah, so I love you guys so much, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Instagram. All right, guys, that's all for this video. If you enjoyed, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Let me know your thoughts on this topic. Do you guys ever diet? Do you have bad dieting problems? Do you guys stay away from dieting and just make it a lifestyle? What do you personally do? I want to hear your opinion. Put it in the comments, and follow me on Instagram if you guys are not part of the Fit Fam on Instagram. And with that being said, I love you guys so much. If you guys have any other topics, please comment them down below for March Madness or April. I'm gonna probably do like some other series, and I just really wanna have content that you guys actually wanna see. So with that being said, I love you guys so much. I'll see you in my next video. I also am going to announce this right now, but in the beginning of April, whole month, I will be doing free macro coaching for anyone that purchases my Teenage Transformation program, which is linked down below. If you purchase the Transformation e-course, which is like a program to get you on track, make a lifestyle rather than being on constant diets and just like failing at them, then this is the e-course for you. It'll change your life, I pinky promise. And I'll be doing nutrition coaching, so if you're interested in that, then it'll be linked down below. But with that being said, I love you guys so much. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I will see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and comment down below any video ideas you have. With that being said, I love you guys so much. so much. You guys are my world, and I'll talk to you guys next week.